So welcome to the US, and it's a pleasure to have you here. And we are following up on our last interview where you had given us a very detailed perspective on things and your visions. So let's start first from the point that you were a student, and I know you from 81 when you came to IIT Kharagpur. And what is your look at all these faces, being a student, then a teacher, then and today the director, where you have all the power to bring all those dreams which you were thinking as a student to the fellow students today?
So first of all, Tejinder, thank you so much, and it's always such a great pleasure to talk to you. You know, when I was a student, I came from a very small Mufassil town. To me, IIT was an unknown entity, and I really didn't know even what to expect of such a great entity. But over the years, as I became a student and I started knowing, IIT has got three, four aspects. It makes a life out of you. It makes you competent enough to face life with all that is required. So it gives you the academic strength, and then it gives you a culture of integrity, and then it gives you the strength to learn and renew. So that is what I learned in IIT. Once you become a faculty in the IIT system, you know, people have great hopes on you. The students look upon you as, and over the years, the students become more and more talented. So they're actually more intelligent than you. And handling people more intelligent than you requires, you know, a different kind of an experience and a challenge. The other thing that I faced while I was a faculty, being a student of an IIT, remaining in an IIT in those years in computer science, and trying to do something, whenever you did try to do something new, set up the VLSI lab, get the first project, set up international quality collaborations, do national-oriented things, people used to say it cannot be done in India. And I was really happy about it. After a few years, and when we have become the director, then, you know, there are four or five things that you have to do. Firstly is the aspiration of the students. Second is the aspiration of the nation. And third is the aspiration of IIT. And all these challenges are difficult. The biggest problem that I face is when now people say, you know, people say it can be done. I think you can do it. That makes me scared. You know, whenever there's a challenge, I'm up to it. But when there's an expectation that we have done something well and we can do something, that really brings up a challenge. So these are the, you know, the three phases, and every day I dream about what we can do for IIT, and through IIT what we can do for this country and the world. And as we have crossed challenge after challenge, our ambitions, our aspirations have grown, and I think we are becoming better and better every day.
Now let's come to the latest in this episode. You are here in the US, so, and you are very active social media guy, so I knew where you are, at the airport, at the this and this. So what is it that you have come here for? What is it that the alumni, the others, you need help from? What is the vision you must have a list of, and how many, you know, you feel you will, they will be ticked, and so I'll let you explain it to us.
Right. See, as our aspirations grow, I have come here for three major stakeholders. One of our biggest stakeholders is our alumni. Now, IIT Kharagpur, as we have enunciated in our new plan, to manage this whole bunch of 12,000 students, 600, 700, 800 faculty cannot do that. However, if we really want to go one step up, we feel that it is our alumni. And the talent that the alumni, the brand that they have built, the experience that they have gained, is going to be enormously important for us. So we are now finding out avenues from minuscule to maxiscule by which alumni can come back and contribute to fostering the institute day by day. So that is why they are our biggest stakeholders. I want to come and hear from them, how they can help. We have formulated several schemes by which alumni can come back and participate in the institute. In fact, one of the schemes was discussed in discussion with the president of India. After I became director and the new president joined office, he invited us. In fact, IIT Kharagpur was the first institute he called, and he talked about the alumni returns to teach program. He talked about our being able to serve the school children as well as education, improve education, make some landmarking things that we reach out to the people. So alumni is forming my base foundation for on which we can catapult to the next stage. So interaction with alumni, finding out how they can help us, sharing our dreams with them is my first. The second is my main job in IIT as director is to recruit the best talent. Recruiting talent and getting the best people into our system is our biggest challenge. Here is where there is a shortage of supply. An IIT faculty need not only be a great researcher. He obviously needs to bring in research. But an IIT faculty has got multiple dimensions, from having your fundamentals absolutely clear, to being able to communicate your fundamentals and your knowledge, being able to bring in your research into the classroom, being able to nurture students who are maybe better than you. And in order to meet the curiosity of this large bunch of students, so I'm really in search of faculty. So that is why I'm interacting with as many prospective people as we want. The third is, as our institute becomes more and more global, internationalization is our next big agenda. We are building a full internationalization program. We are building hostels for international people. We are building accommodation for international faculty. We have opened up our doors for all sorts of people to come in. And we are looking for joint collaborations with best-in-class institutions for our programs. So we are going all over the world. And the United States, as you know, has got some of the best institutions in the world in each of their areas. So we are willing to work with many of them, and we are going to forge many such collaborations with individual institutions as well as with consortium of institutions. And fourthly, most important is, you know, many people do not know, you know, what is the big achievement of IIT Kharagpur. So that is why, as you said, I'm on the social media, not only to inform people about where I am, but to let people know that in that backyard of a railway colony, we drive some of the foundational programs, not only of our country, but some which are impacting the world.
That really sums it up. But in there are three points you raised. The first one, so with the alumni, you have this, I like to suggest that there are alumni organizations here, but also if you can make, do you want to make an open appeal to people who are not involved with these organizations? There are people who are silent workers, but very dedicated to their alma mater, who are very proud of being from there. And you being active on social media may be able to reach out to them.
Yeah, you know, you're absolutely correct. While organizational structures help, we as IITians are fairly flat in our connect, and this social media and other connect helps it enormously to connect with people who have very, very good ideas, very, very good strength. So what we have done is, we are picking up categories of people who are at various age groups, and these age group people are the people who come with different sets of ideas, and they enrich us. So I'm engaging individually, I'm engaging with people who, as you said, are very silent, but who make very important contributions. So we are very keen to connect with them, and we are very keen. I'm getting on my Facebook now, or you know, and on my email, all people who want to say, I want to meet with you, I want to do this, I want to do that. It's very exciting.
And on this topic of internationalization, I remember when we were there, we had students from Iran, Kuwait, Malaysia. So there was an international community of students there. But now it seems that it is expanding more to the advanced Western countries. And those students were mostly of Indian origin. But are you reaching out for real internationalization? The students who are not of Indian origin or heritage need to come and make it a breeding ground of harmonized learning.
You're perfect. You're on the dot. See, there are 3-4 kinds of people who want IIT. One is a set of people who are from countries where they do not have an education at the level of IIT. So getting the best talent from those countries, including our SAARC countries, including Asia, and giving them the IIT quality education is of benefit to us because we can attract the best talent there. How are we going, what is a person from US, from Europe, going to come to us to work with us for? People used to think that they'll come to us for data, collection of data. That's where we are good at. No. We are now solving problems for which people would like to come to India to solve. They won't get to solve that problem anywhere else because the expertise is not there. I'll give you an example. We are looking at data science and Indian music. And how are we going to study the modern structure, the grammar of Indian music? And Indian music is very unique. Now, in order to do that, you really have to come to India. Adepts are not there. Similarly, we are trying to solve some of the challenges of cognitive learning and education, which is at the heart of the next generation AI. And AI is a big theme for my visit this time. And for that, if you really need to look at children of multiple languages, multiple levels of, you know, upbringing, and look at all that analytics which we want to do, and you want to really study all that, you have to come to India. And we are getting people wanting to come to India, and that is why what we have done is, we have built up a set of 10 thematic areas, 6 of them being techno-commercial, techno-convergence, and 4 of them being socio-convergence areas, where people would like to come. Now, if you want to solve a very complex transportation problem, India's transportation problem is completely different from what you would solve anywhere else. You want to solve an affordable healthcare problem, you need to come to India. You want to solve the food sustainability problem, you have to come to India. So now, we are solving such problems where people from the developed world will not get such a problem to solve in their country.
You mentioned artificial intelligence. I've been very interested in this, especially in terms of e-discovery, which we already have an institute there, Vinod Gupta has set up. And the e-discovery is here in the US is not yet really boom, but it has a big potential because of the languages, the spectrum of languages in India. And so what is your focus about the artificial intelligence, and do you have a program or a vision to impart it into that e-discovery, which is an amazing but exponentially expanding arena?
This is, we have broken up our AI program into four quadrants. The first quadrant is about advanced research. What are the advances of research in AI and its linkages with all other subjects? The second is about education. India needs massive, massive AI level education. The education that is provided in AI is so minuscule, quality education. And the requirements for retraining in that area is enormous. So we are going to develop this large scale program of AI education and capacity building, not only in colleges or college graduates, but in the industry. For that, we are going to build up a major national AI platform, which will produce content, which will produce material, software, and infrastructure behind it, so that the whole nation can utilize this infrastructure and catapult themselves. The third is about building, and it's on this platform, which has going to have a back end of our national digital library, which we have developed, where there are more than 17 million content free for everybody in India, which is touching the tips of every person, is around this, on which we are working on 130 languages. It is around this we are building the e-discovery platform. And then we have two more quadrants. One is on industry-driven research, where we are working on commercial angles of research, where we are working on marketing, retail, etc. We are working on socio angles of research, where we are looking at the whole data of rural India, up to household level. And then trying to figure out, what are the national interventions required for us to really transform rural India. We have figured out partially what to do with underground water. We're going to figure out what is going to do with women empowerment, what is going to do with technologies. So each of them is going to come up. And then we are working in areas where India looks to the Western world for its technology, like areas of petroleum, hydrocarbons. The whole of the AI there is done by experts outside. So we would like to now develop in-house experts for ourselves. So, these are the areas where we are moving. And the fourth is entrepreneurship. AI entrepreneurship is becoming the key focus of our graduates. So we really want to foster, IITians are now slowly, slowly getting into entrepreneurship. They are really, a large chunk of them are not interested in jobs. And this entrepreneurship need not be only a commercial success, it can be a social success. So we are going to work on the AI entrepreneurship as the fourth quadrant.
So I think enough of about here. Let's shift back thousands of miles away, back home, where when this is uploaded, I'm sure the students and the teachers and the other interested people will watch this. So the campus, the last time we interviewed PPC was in a beautiful setting in the IIT campus, and he raised some very good points. And let's go back and see where those visions have reached. So first of all, the hospital, which was a big problem in our time and has been continuously. And you had said in our last interview that it is on the way. So can you update us on that?
So I'm very happy to tell you that the 400-bed hospital, the whole building has almost got completed. And by next year, we will be starting a 400-bed super speciality hospital in one of the most remotest areas of this country, backed up by IIT Kharagpur. Again, IIT, it will be the first among the IITs to set up such a hospital, following which we will set up the medical program. We already have a School of Medical Science and Technology, and I believe that this hospital, where we are going to have collaborations nationally with institutions like AIIMS, with Tata Medical Centers, as well as internationally, for which some of the interactions I'm going to have here, is going to be a game changer.
Then the other one was that you had a vision about, say, 20 kilometer radius around IIT, of which is very rural, to kind of develop, kind of provide them with something which is cheap, which is really down to earth. Where are we on that?
So some very, very exciting things have happened there. So, you know, after we spoke, there was a village called Kenthia, which was about 18 acres of land, which was fallow for 8 years. And people were, you know, not able to even earn their bread and butter. They were earning about 1,000, 1,500 rupees a year. So we gave them a plan, and we offered them, saying that we will provide you technology, cropping, and the new techniques of water harvesting, organic farming, and you have to develop this land. So they said, yes, we are willing to work for so many rupees per day. So we said, we're not going to pay you. So they said, why should we work? We said, you can take the harvest, sell it, and earn. So that year, in the first year, when we set everything up with our budget, in the first year, they had the bumper harvest, the best in the district. Next year, we started taking away. We said, we won't give you seed, we won't give you manure, you buy it. The next year, we said, water and electricity, you pay. And we have slowly, slowly taken off. And that, and you can imagine in a place like West Bengal with 4 political parties, 5 political parties, all of them supporting us. They have signed on the same piece of paper saying that we want you to help us. We have got now 10 offers from 10 other villages to do that. We have a complete sustainable plan. We have now, and you talked about technologies for the poor. You know, you are from that place. Have you remember people making this puffed rice on Moody?
Yeah.
On a kadhai? We have made a machine for them.
Oh, wow.
And that machine previously used to work on sal leaves. It now works on electricity, it works on gas, it works on solar. And the lady who used to make this and earn 1,000 rupees a month is earning 12,000 rupees a month. We are now sending this all out to Northeast India. We have changed the whole potter's wheel. There's a person who used to make that potter's wheel. Now this person sits on electricity and makes, you know, designer pottery. So we are using technology. We are, because of IIT Kharagpur scale from, you know, nanoscience to agriculture, anything that is required we are able to do. So we've made some very, very good pilot successes. The recent thing which we did was, in one village, a villager gave us land. We set up a water plant, and we have a mechanism there for that village, where everybody has a water ATM card for family, and they pay 1 rupee, and they get 15 liters of water a day. They run it themselves, and it's completely set up for them. So we've got these successes. Now, in the next few years, we are really going to ensure that entrepreneurship comes out. So now we are converting the Muri making manufacturing machine to them, so that they can. So we are scaling up, and now we are building some new institutions around this for their training. So agriculture, farming, 3D printing, IoTs, all of that is going to, so we want to kickstart this whole area into a new dimension.
There's just one point that strikes me, is that when you said about the Kenthia village, the village, are you looking to involve industry or something where it can go on a mass scale, not one village, but...
All right. You know, that is the challenge here. And how are we going to ensure that the growth is now multiplicative, is a challenge that we are working on. Okay. And I think you've said the right point. Our proof of concepts are done, cost effectiveness is done, now scaling up.
Okay.
is what we need.
So, what are the challenges that the students are facing today? Because you have a perspective from both sides, and I know that students do, there are students who do confide with you, you are very approachable, I've been told. So, what are the challenges that you think the students today are facing?
So, Tejinder, I have worked this out in a very interesting way. In India, one thing that everybody knows is about cricket.
Okay.
Everybody is a specialist in cricket.
Okay.
So now I have benchmarked the students to cricket. So once you do that benchmark, your answers will become very clear. Your time, my time, were the times of Sunil Gavaskar and Vishwanath.
Yeah.
Where we were good, we were defensive, we knew when we go to the world, we will play well, and over a period of time, we will succeed. But then Indian cricket transformed. The mentality, aspirations of students have transformed. Today, they have crossed the Ganguly phase, they have crossed the Sachin phase, they are now in the Dhoni and Virat Kohli phase, that we are going to challenge the world. And that is why they want a different kind of facilitation from us. The facilitation that we wanted was funda from faculty. Now they want that I will not only have funda, but I will want to demonstrate something that I can do while I am here. Give me that facility. So that is the mindset change. And the second thing is we were all treated as bulk. Class, everybody is given the same medicine for that class. Today, you have to teach them as individuals. So that is the challenge. And unless you are approachable, unless you can hear everyone's that aspiration, that talent, and that difficulty, you're not going to be, you can apply some common medicines, common technologies, but you really have to have a very, very flexible structure. So that is the difference, and that is the challenge. If we can solve that challenge well, then India will really mass produce, you know, the best people.
You mentioned the word facilitation. Mm. Now, you are in US. In US, there are huge scholarships which are sports-based. And in India, at IIT, let's talk about, there are athletes, there are players who are world-class. But they don't have all the facilities. They don't have financial backing. I personally know some of the very dedicated students. And so is there anything that you, in your tenure, will like to
Absolutely, do? Absolutely. By the middle of next year, we are going to have world-class track and field. The whole order has been placed. The Gyankho Stadium is going to become a world-class track and field. The whole layout is changed and is going to change. We are going to build another students' facilitation program for having really top-class, you know, indoor games. You will be very happy to know that we got a very good athletics coach, and this time we won for the first time in the history of IIT Kharagpur 2 medals in the state championship. So now we are actually going to come to Senate to, you know, recognize that this is as important. So what I've said before is that IIT Kharagpur has produced everything, CEOs, faculty, entrepreneurs, journalists. 2 things we have left. We've produced ministers, we've produced chief ministers, you know, everything is done. One, we will produce a judge of the Supreme Court. And secondly, we will produce an athlete who represents India. And I think that will be the wholesome, you know, outcome of an institution like ours.
I'm not sure how good you mentioned about the new indoor games and all, about the, say, basketball courts.
So we are going to change that basketball court into an indoor
because
court.
Is it still the same?
It is the same court that you have seen, Mr.
Okay.
Teji. So it requires change.
So, and then there are, you know, for the teams who do, the members who do well, to provide them with special shoes, things like that.
So that is being done.
Okay.
That is being done. But The basketball court needs change. The tennis courts needs change.
It's still the same one.
No. The tennis courts have changed.
Okay.
But the basketball has not changed.
Okay. So now you've given a lot of time, but I would like, on a sum up basis, how will you define your dictatorship?
Dictatorship?
Yes. That's how we termed it. That I used it intentionally. Because in our time, directorship was dictatorship. So, today you are running a directorship. So, how will you define your directorship today? And what is the vision you have? You know, I'm sure you're going to leave a big legacy behind. But for the vision and your, you know, say, short message to the alumni, the students right down there, because these are the people who are going to become tomorrow the support for the IIT system. And then anything else that you would like to add?
See, you know, I was asked this question a few days ago, and I said the strategy of my dictatorship or directorship, as you call it, is threefold. And my head is in that dreaming sky where we want to dream like for the future of the best people in India. As I said, I always say that there are two things about an IIT education. One is we get the best people. They are like amanat, desh ka amanat. The second is that the people of India pay for this education.
Yes.
It is the poorest people of India who pay for this education in the hope that they will change their lives. So your dreams must be solid. Secondly, your heart must beat with the stakeholders. And the stakeholders are the students, the faculty, the alumni, the staff, and all the other stakeholders, the government, and everybody else. But the third step is most important. Your feet must be on the ground. The heart of solving any problem that I have now realized in these 5 years is execution, execution, execution. You can have great ideas, but it is better to have a simple idea and execute it completely than have a great idea and not do anything. So I think that has been my sum. That is why I'm trying to connect with everybody. I try to pass on the message. I try to share these big dreams. The second is about giving them this, you know, one thing that has remained constant about IIT education is about the quality of making a life. It's just not the academics, but in the academics, the foundation was the quote-unquote fundamentals. So I still think that we offer very good teaching in the fundamentals, but in the world of making things, discovery. So, for example, all our lab experiments are about taking readings, measuring things, plotting it, and seeing that this law works. We hardly have an experiment which says, oh, here is something we need to explore. Can you design an experiment to do that? So, the whole concept of design thinking, product thinking, implementation thinking, it's not about skill. It's about bringing all this together. So that is where we need to build our system, and that is where our students are capable. The third thing is we need to build things for the nation and the world. We have built the National Digital Library of India, which today works with the American Library of Congress, and we works with the OECD Library of Europe, which works with the Australian Library. We are driving the whole digital rights campaign. And I think that this is where we really need to move. The third thing is IIT Kharagpur's uniqueness of having a technology-focused institution, which is now like a university. So all disciplines which require science, technology, social science amalgamation, we are the ones who can really drive it. So here is something that we have aspirations for. We are trying to solve some unique problems. We have a project called Science and Heritage Initiative, where we are amalgamating science and heritage. We have a program on food security. We have a program on infrastructure. We have a program called the Future of the Earth. So we are looking at social aspects, technology aspects, amalgamation. We are the first institute which is Vinod Gupta set up this school of law. We are running a course called AI and Law. So how does AI affect law? It's very unique in India. So I think, you know, we have, you know, very good challenges, but our goal is also to partner with the best in the world. We alone cannot do everything, even though we are very big. So we are now going to work with, you know, I'm going to have good meetings with MIT and various other institutions here, and then all over the world. So the message for the students is that, you know, education, we are here to facilitate your talent. You are extremely talented, but talent can only be facilitated by extreme hard work, absolute knowledge of fundamentals. And today the world, we will make available all facilities. But everybody has to struggle to do that learning. And that struggle is something that we want to ensure is so enriching for you that, you know, you can work really hard. We want to ensure that the best people of the world come into our campus and intermingle with us, solve some of the foundational problems that are required in the world, and solve some of the really important problems of India. Because if you can solve these problems of India, you'll actually be able to scale it up all over the world in many of the countries. So the IITians now have an onerous challenge of taking things forward. We will be happy as being the first IIT, the institution which has led so many changes in the IIT system, to be, you know, the frontliner in taking this forward, so that all of us, including all the IITs and the other institutions of this country, are able to really get this great, you know, diversity of our talent to fructification. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And this one, the last one, is for the students who have reached out to me repeatedly over the last few years since I, you know, been going there, is the people who are interested in journalism. Mm. There are, you know, very good on social media portals like Awaj, Scholars Avenue, and things like that. And I see people, you know, they love to have their titles, you know, editors, sub-editors, and all. What I will suggest on behalf of our media group, India America Today, is that in case the director decides to go ahead and have a short, you know, courses on journalism there, we can even bring you here to the Washington, D.C. and get you, say, summer internship, spring internship, or winter internship, and you go and attend White House briefings, State Department briefings, and meet the senators, meet the lawmakers. So there is a big opportunity there. So with that,
we have started something called micro-specializations, where you can specialize on any subject. And this is a very unique thing of IIT Kharagpur, where student who is doing mining engineering is specializing, doing a micro-specialization in IPR. A student who is doing metallurgy is doing embedded wireless systems. And now we are going to do management. And I think the idea that you've done is something like media and journalism can come in as a micro-specialization, and we can work on it.
Because then IIT Kharagpur student will be the first one who will be attending a White House briefing. And it is, you know, it's the sky is the limit. Because personally, I was, as you know, born and brought up in Kharagpur,
went to Kharagpur,
got kicked out of IIT Kharagpur. And I am where I am today, by God's grace, and by that, you mentioned one word, that IIT Kharagpur makes a life out of you. It is not just the degree, it is not the studies only, it is the experience of being there. So enjoy it and you have one of the best directors. So take advantage.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Very much.